Welcome back to our studio. Today I'm working on this bougainvillea in our painting in the south of France, Côte d'Azur. Now I have painted the bougainvillea on the other side of the arch. This is more in the background. I've used mixtures of permanent rose plus magenta plus white on this one. A lot of magenta in there, because I want that pink to be cooler. This bougainvillea is also going to be pink, but it's going to have some mixes of permanent rose plus cadmium red light, which will make that warmer and make it come forward. But right now I'm blocking in the flowers in the shadow, so these again are the magenta plus the permanent rose. That permanent rose is a really nice color. It makes a real good hot pink that I just can't achieve with mixing like alizarin crimson and white or any of my other colors. So that makes me a good bougainvillea color. But I want to get my basic shape of my bougainvillea blocked in, and then I'll start adding some of the warmer colors. Now these bracts, which are what we call the flowers on the bougainvillea, actually are not flowers, they're called bracts. The flowers of the bougainvillea are really a little tiny white flower in the middle of these pink, kind of, they're big, puffy, circular, I call them flowers, but technically they're bracts. But anyway, they're the color of the bougainvillea. And this is a wall here in the foreground that's coming forward. So this bougainvillea is going to be breaking out over that wall in the background. And now this is some of my permanent rose plus cadmium red light. You can see that color is warmer, and so that will come forward of our bougainvillea in the background. Makes kind of a nice salmon pink color. I block in my flowers first. This is so that when I come back in and do the leaves, your brush picks up some of that underlying color. And by painting my flower color first, then when I paint the greens around it, I don't muddy my flowers. If I were to paint the greens first and then came back and paint the flowers, or the flower color, then the green would muddy my color, and it would just wouldn't have that nice, pretty, bright color. This bougainvillea is going to have little clumps coming down. Then I'll paint the wall in and around this down here. I wasn't real sure how far down I wanted to go with this bougainvillea, so I thought, well, I'll do the wall after I get this painted in. And there's some of these come down. That's Molly talking in the background, saying hi. Put another little arm. Let's see, let this arm come out here. My sky's still a little bit wet, so it makes it easier to paint this wet into wet. There's a little smaller brush here. And I'm going to use some of my pink mixture too in here. Flowers are not all the same color. You get a variation in the different pinks. And these bougainvilleas just send out all kinds of neat arms just dangling out there. They're really a neat, pretty plant. Some darks in here. And I just sort of smush that paint up there. I'll work the greens around it. But I want this top part to be lighter because the light's coming through and hitting on the top of that. And then this down here and toward the edge will be darker. Now I keep wiping my brush. So I want my color to remain clean. Now I'm going to come back in, I have saved my wall color. The wall is mixtures of my mud, which is ultramarine blue plus alizarin crimson, plus cadmium orange, plus a little bit more ultramarine blue. And I've saved mixtures of that, and I can come back in and paint around my flower color. So I want there to be openings in between my different, those arms of the bougainvillea coming out. You want to see the background, want to see that wall back there. That helps give the feeling of distance in the painting. Give some air in there. See how my brush picks up that color from the pinks and stuff. So I have to keep wiping my brush because I also want my flower or my wall color to remain clean. I'll bring some blues in there to make that go back. And it's a subtle thing. The blues are the complementary color to the oranges. The cadmium red light is more toward the orange, so that blue makes it appear more vibrant. Across from each other on the color wheel. Placing complementary colors next to each other makes them appear more vibrant. So again, I just want to work some darks in here from that wall back in there, back in the background. Give some air in there. So be a little bit darker there. Clean my brush real good. This paint is still wet, so I want to pull that. Smooth that transition just a little bit. This wall is going to be dark back here. This wall is going to be lighter. So I want that wall to be darker and cooler, so it goes back. And add some more blues in here. And this blue mixture is my mud, plus more ultramarine blue, plus a tiny bit of cadmium orange just to dull it a little bit. I'm going to bring my trunk here. This is a mixture of mud plus liquin. And I can just pull that in to the wet paint and make one of my little trunks. Just wind around here. Now let's start walking in the leaves. Put my big brush again. Get all the pink out of it. I use a lot of tissue. Now my greens are mixes of viridian green plus a little bit of cadmium yellow medium plus white. And so let's start blocking in our foliage back here. You can see how my brush is picking up that pink, so I want to keep that cleaned. Around. I want to make clumps of those colorful bracts. And here I'm using a little mixture of some phthalo blue plus white. I want to give variation within the foliage, and the phthalo blue plus white gives me a nice cool color. When you look at leaves and plants, they're not all the same green, and as the foliage goes back more into the depths, you get more cool colors, so that blue helps to add some coolness into that. I'm already getting a feel for the shape of that bougainvillea draping over this foreground. sides, and these are a little bit wider. Now I'm going to start moving down to a little smaller brush. And you can see I can use, even though that's a fairly large brush, I can use the corner of that brush to get some smaller brush strokes, get my detail. Let's use a little bit darker green in here. This to be darker underneath here. Now the arms of the bougainvillea are long, long, viney. Let's see how I want this to come down. I'm trying to determine how I'm going to have that arm come down. Okay, I want to have it come like so. And these just are pulled into that wet sky so I can make those graceful curves a whole lot easier while that paint's wet. This one's going to end right here. And then we get another one coming out this way. Okay, now I have four there. I want to have an odd number. That's just more pleasing for the eye. Let's see, where do I want my fifth one to come? Do I want it to come up here? Now let's let one come down. Yeah, let's let one. Well, I'm going to have, in here, I'm going to have gladioli coming up. So I don't want that to come too far down. Let's bring one right there. Okay. Start using a little lighter mixture of, we're using cadmium red plus white and also the cadmium red light plus permanent rose plus white. And this gives me warmer and lighter colors where that sun is hitting my bougainvillea. I let this paint really glob on there. Now we're going to let this one come down a little further. But you can see with that cadmium red light mixed into those pinks, that really comes forward. Makes that a lot warmer, comes forward of the bougainvilleas in the back. I'm going to move to a little bit bigger brush. I want to get these here. This is how I paint a bougainvillea. It's just a lot of, you come back in, you kind of work around the masses of color and start picking up areas that you want to highlight where the sunlight hits these. I appreciate you watching my YouTube videos. And I hope you'll visit my blog. The link is in the description below. I also have the address on the final frame of my video. And please subscribe. So there we go. I have a little bit more work to do on this. I want to just take a break from it and come back and look at it. Then I will show you the finished bougainvillea at the end of this video. So you have a wonderful, wonderful day, and thank you again for following along.